engineer from Mega. Today we're going to talk about the MSF10 and HVB. The agenda will be MSF10 and HVB, and what it does, what's the differences, how it works, and sheath hook endpoint. So examples of what a sheath hook is. It's damage to the jacket, usually mechanical damage through installation or repairs. We use it onshore and offshore wind farms because of the length of the cable. Solar farms because they're usually unarmored. HV cables and LV cables. So what's the differences? The HVB main application is insulation faults and sheath faults. Dischargeable capacity of up to 25 microfarads. Maximum current is 200 milliamps. Minimal measurable voltage is 5 microvolts. The MSF10 main application is the sheath fault. Dischargeable capacity 10 microfarads. Maximum current 750 milliamps. Measurable voltage is 20 microvolts. Cable capacity is automatically measured. If it exceeds the maximum capacity of the discharge, the maximum voltage will be limited. Other differences, the MSF10 is cheaper than HVB. Connection cable of the HVB has one more wire to keep voltage and current measurements separate at near end connections. The algorithm of the MSF10 is optimized stabilized fault current. Faults are unstable flashover or leakage current behavior. Both units are using two auxiliary wires for pre-location. One to take the HV to the far end, one to take the measurement meter to the far end. Only if absolutely necessary and with big losses in accuracy, both units can be operated with one auxiliary wire. But it must be identified to the faulty wire sheet. In this case, the end of cable length must be doubled. Far end bridge should be low resistance, big diameter, solid clamps to reduce influences of the bridge resistance. The HVB is the HVB10 is a high voltage bridge and can be seen an alternative to ARM, which is our protection method. HVB gives good with very high resistive faults. Very long cable, up to approximately 200 kilometers. But pinpointing will be difficult unless the fault is broken through the cable jacket and the surge generator is not part of the test kit. The MSF10 has one pre-location load, which is standard, but the HVB has two pre-location loads, standard and high accuracy. The standard load provides two good results. A good result is the typical sheath fault. And fault resistance up to some hundreds of kilohms, and the shield cross section of the range from 25 to 50 millimeters squared. This measurement is typically done in approximately 30 seconds. The high accuracy mode takes approximately 1 minute for the algorithm to complete, but will utilize the full potential of the measuring and control surface of the instrument. Thus, it is ideally suited for pre-locating difficult, high resistive faults, for example, in the inner insulation of field cable. An intermittent fault detection algorithm is applied to gain the result under even worse conditions with spark faults. Right, how did it work? The technical data for the MSF10 in red is the differences between the MSF10 and the HVB. The technical data for the HVB. Pre-location methods. High voltage measuring bridge. Balance of the bridge. Circuit, good connection between bridge and cable, equal resistance, faulty and auxiliary line. Volt drop method. The relation of the volt drop method is front and behind the fault, so it measures both areas of the fault. Advantages of the volt drop method. Much less error sensitive compared to bridge-based methods, resulting in significantly higher accuracy for pre-location results. Independent from the difference in the sheath and the core conductor resistance. Independent from the resistance of the supplementary wires. Automatically calculation of the result without the need for additional entries. Fast measurements, no moving parts, no calibration procedure required. Actually, you're better than 0.1%. Why do we use bipolar? Differences of temperature inside a conductor causes thermoelectric flares that can be recognized as polarized offset voltage. This offset voltage can influence the measurement voltage, but the result can be distorted. Harmonic effects are a result of chemical elements inside the soil, balls, metal salts. They can affect the measurement results in a combination of metallic earthstones, moisture of soil, and measurement current. Erosion at the sheath bolt itself or other parts of the conductor, for example, wet joints, can also lead to distorted results due to galvanic effects. By using bipolar measurement, recurring offset voltages can be detected and eliminated easily during the measurement, and pulsatile effects can be eliminated. Simple circuit diagram of how a cable is connected and how we do the measurement. Sheath rock location. PVC, PE, outer sheath. PV sheath test, 3 kV, or PE sheath test, 5 kV. Do the sheath test, depending on the current of the voltage it holds. If it holds, no recaption required. If the sheath current is less, then you bridge both method. Do we have an auxiliary wire available? If we do, and if we do it, can we pinpoint? Is the cable in a duct? Recommended standard for sheath. PV sheath test, 3 kV, PE isolation, 3 kV, PPE isolation, 3 kV, PE, 5 kV. Recommend maximum current for test, PE sheath, 100 microamps per kilometer, PV sheath, 800 microamps per kilometer. Recommended test during duration is approximately 10 minutes. Connection for sheath bolt pre-location. There's the differences between the MFM 10 and the HVB, how you connect for a sheath bolt pre-location. Connection for insulation bolt pre-location. Connection with only one auxiliary wire or less. Note, enter the double cable now. The drilling conductor should be similar to a faulty conductor and is less precise. The volt drop method. Pre-location or to shield. Alternative to the arm procedure, depending on the characteristics of the bolt, current flow is necessary in application for very long cables, usually offshore wind farms. Sheath bolt location, conductive sheath. Dry or ground rear conduit for ducts and cisterns. We'll turn current through the earth, semiconductive layer, guard leading auxiliary earth. Semiconductive sheath, dry ground or in a conduit. Application of multiple bolts. As there is two faults with very similar resistances, the pre-location will give you a result midway between the two faults, as the virtual point is indicated. And it depends on the resistances. The closer the resistances are together of the faults, the more equal it will be between them. If one has a higher resistance, the lower resistance will have a fault closer to it. The screen of what the pre-location would look like shows you the near end and far end resistances and voltages. Sheath bolt pinpointing. High sensitivity measuring arrangements, from 0.01 millivolts to 200 volts. Automatic adaption to the voltage. Suppression of external disturbances. Elimination of DC influences. Automatic zero adjustment. Automatic detection of pulse rate. Easier handling without permanent adjustment. Mechanically strong and electrically safe construction of the earthworks. Display unit has an IP54 rating. Advantages of DC step voltage method. No wrong measurement by capacitive coupling. No interferences of 50 Hz or short switch pulses. No change of the fault point by location method itself. Disadvantages of DC step voltage. No sensitivity. External voltages in the saw must be newly compensated for each case. Responsible for the limit and the application. In case of the presence of several faults, highly resistive faults will not spark over the sensitivity decrease. Choice of settings, bar graph or history. Bar graph and the history pulses. The voltage method is connected to the generator. Sheath pinpointing, pulse and ground contact. Pinpointing when you have two